So let's talk about this concept of a measurement error. Now, whenever we measure something, we need to understand the idea that there is an actual true value. This is the value that we're trying to figure out. We're trying to figure out what the true value of this thing really is. Now, you're going to take your individual measurement, and it's going to be off. And there's two primary reasons that it's going to be off. It's going to be different from the actual value. The first is a bias, which may or may not occur. It is possible to get rid of biases. And the other is chance error. Well, you can't get rid of chance error. Typically, you can't. You can help reduce it. You can help control it. You can work with it. You can understand it. But you can't typically get rid of chance error. So as an example, you're trying to measure something. And let's just say that we're talking Christmas trees. You go buy a Christmas tree, and they put up on the stand, and based on the height, that's what you pay for it. Well, it's on a stand. So when it's up on the stand, you may have this bias in that every tree is actually 6 or 8 inches taller, or is reported to be 6 or 8 inches taller than what it really is. That's what we mean when we say a bias is a systematic tendency of the sample to represent the population. Now, a chance error is just simply, it's random. We think of chance error, commonly referred to or sometimes referred to as white noise. Chance error is random and it bounces around. We'll come back and talk about that in a second. So let's just suppose that this bias for this Christmas tree was, I'm going to say 8 inches. And let's just say on a particular tree that we knew the chance error was 6 inches. So let's just say the 8 inches was an over-measurement and the 6 inches was an under-measurement because of chance error. Well, combined, that means we have 2 inches. Our actual measurement is 2 inches higher than what it should be. So by subtracting that 2, we can actually get the actual value. It would be dead on. Now, in reality, we can't figure that out. We can't always find what the chance error is on that measurement. And we can't always find what the bias is. So we can't actually get the true actual value. But if we can help eliminate the bias and help reduce the chance error, then this individual measurement would be a very close approximation to the actual value. Now, a bias sample is one that's falsely taken to be typical of the population which is drawn. So let's go back to this Christmas tree example. If we want to know what the average height of all the Christmas trees was that we sold this year, and everyone was measured sitting up on an 8-inch stand, well, it is a false measurement. So this whole sample is falsely taken to be typical. We would use that as an average. Now, this is assuming that we didn't really know, or we didn't really realize that we had an 8-inch overestimate on every tree. But in reality, we did. So we're falsely taking this biased sample to be representative of the population. Now, error due to chance, that chance error I was talking about earlier, first thing to understand that regarding chance error is that the chance error is a result of the measurement process and not the object that's actually being measured. And the chance error randomly over and estimates. It kind of bounces around, whereas a bias is one-sided. Typically, it's always overestimating or underestimating. And there's nothing systematic about it. There's nothing systematic about chance error. In reality, because chance error kind of bounces around, I know that's not very scientific, but it really does describe it pretty well. The effect of random error on measurements, and you have a bunch of measurements, tend to cancel themselves out a little bit. Because some will be over, some will be under, and overall the amount of error is not all that great. But we do want to do whatever we can to help control the chance error.